Okay. Interesting news from the president about his Thanksgiving.
Well, we had to keep everybody updated. What is Joe Biden doing for Thanksgiving? Most of the time, they go home. You know, he's actually been to Delaware. He goes there all the time. No worries. You know, that's where he's from. But President Biden chose to spend Thanksgiving in a little bit of a different environment, more befitting a man of his stature. Let's put this up there on the screen. He has decided to spend his Thanksgiving meal at the $30 million Nantucket home of private equity billionaire David Rubenstein. Interesting. So the White House confirmed that Biden and his family would spend the long weekend at Carlyle Group co-founder David Rubenstein's $30 million property. He would be traveling abroad and he would not be at the dinner. So he went ahead and said, oh, well, Mr. President, you are very welcome to sit here at our Nantucket estate, of which we won't be at. It is completely at your it's completely at your discretion. These are the types of just ridiculous and naked displays where Biden feels as if he will suffer no consequence while people are having the most expensive Thanksgiving meal of their lives. And no, undoubtedly, I bet it was a topic of discussion. Hopefully you all followed Krystal's lead and did not bring up anything annoying and political. But
that was controversial, by the way.
Oh, really? Yeah. I'm surprised by that. I lived by it at my own meal. And I think it's very important, though, that people, what were people talking about? Inflation and gas prices, probably schools as well. If you put those three together, to the extent that anyone was talking about current events, it was those. And while he's doing that, he's dining, you know, at the home of this private equity billionaire. I'd also question, did he pay him rent? Because, you know, I seem to recall, who was that idiot, the EPA administrator, Scott Atlas?
Oh, yeah.
Or whatever. No, not Scott Atlas. Sorry. Scott Pruitt, that was the name, the EPA guy, who ended up staying in somebody's house and not paying him any rent. Anyway, when you're a government official, you're not supposed to actually take these types of in-kind benefits. Although I guess when you're the president, you're exempt, as we found out under Trump. So I guess it's cool. But yeah, I mean, I think it's a pretty disgusting display of wealth to be in a $30 million mansion at the home of a private equity billionaire, not even in your own house, nakedly shoving it in people's faces. He was hanging out at all of these like rich stores in Nantucket. And look, once again, like if you're a private citizen, fine, but you're the president of the United States. He's hanging out there with Hunter Biden and, you know, his grandchildren going to like these different shops.
Clearly following in Obama's footsteps.
Yeah, following, exactly. Obama actually lives on Martha's Vineyard in Massachusetts. So, you know, it's the perfect display. And at the very same time, Krystal, the Politico, you know, put out kind of a Thanksgiving special. Let's put this up there on the screen. The Democratic brand is broken.
Really?
The infrastructure bill isn't fixing
it. I wonder why.
Now,
gee.
What I love here is that they focus on a focus group actually put together by Third Way. Now, as you said, you know, you may have an ideological difference with Third Way, but their focus groups are actually pretty good. And these are just direct quotes, you know, from people in suburban Virginia. And what they point to time and time again is that even with the Democrats, you know, expecting to lose their house and more, is that it is going to be even worse than we could possibly imagine. Because what the focus group point to is that voters believe the economy is bad. No amount of stats can change their mind in terms of the White House and Kamala Harris, you know, putting out these ridiculous charts being like, actually, everything is fine. They say jobs numbers, wage numbers, the number of people we've put back to work, it does not move them. Instead, we should still talk about the things like more wages and back to normal, but realize that they don't have impact whenever people see help wanted signs all over Main Street, restaurant sections closed for lack of workers, rising prices and supply disruptions, even where things are getting better. Biden does not get the credit. And what they actually point to within is the disconnect between the stuff they feel is going on in your life and then all the stuff happening here in Washington. Cinema, tax increase on this, no carried interest loophole. Also, none of the social programs will really impact you all that much because of all the means testing, all that stuff.
Yep.
Very hard to understand. So, irrelevant. At the same time, pump, more expensive. Gas station, more expensive. Exactly what's going on in day-to-day life. I mean, I'm not the only guy who's seen this. You go all over this country, you can't go into a place without a help wanted sign or something like that. And it's just completely disrupting the way that life was supposed to be. Biden said we go back to normal. It's not normal. And you put that all together, especially with the lack of legislative vision from the White House. And what? I mean, he's been almost president for almost a year at this point. It's on you now, dude.
So. Well, the funniest part is they said most of the voters Third Way spoke with in suburban Virginia focus groups, according to the report, quote, could not articulate what Democrats stand for. They could also not say what they are doing in Washington besides fighting. The irony of Third Way putting out this report and doing these focus groups is they are part of the reason that Democrats stand for nothing. Like, their answer to this would be like, that's why they should do even less. That's why they should means test even more. But the insights for the voters are very interesting. Look, as we've been saying here, the biggest problem for Democrats honestly is optics like Pelosi officiating the Ivy Getty wedding, or Biden at a freaking private equity billionaire's house on Thanksgiving. I mean, you could not possibly write a better attack ad for how out of touch this man has become from the people that he was sent there to serve. And it's not as if Carlyle Group doesn't have, you know, impending business before the federal government. This is something that our friend David Sirota pointed out, which was quoted in this piece. Quote, President Biden is vacationing at the Nantucket home of a billionaire whose private equity firm is right now lobbying to shape Biden's final Build Back Better bill. It's already very let them eat cake for a president to hang out at a billionaire's Nantucket pad, but it is some real Gilded Age shit when the billionaire's private equity firm has all sorts of interests before the government right now. So it's not just the optics, right. It's also the corruption. Yeah. It's also the fact that, I mean, this just underscores again who our political class actually serves, who they see themselves as part of their social circle, who they're socializing with, and human beings being how they are, those are then the views that end up shaping your thoughts and ultimately the legislation that is passed. That's why this is such a problem. And just to show you, I mean, Glenn Youngkin, who just got elected in Virginia, was a Carlyle Group executive
for decades.
And Terry McAuliffe, who was running against him as the Democrat, couldn't point it out because he had made massive investments in Carlyle Group. And they are just as nefarious as your average private equity firm. In fact, they first came to major public prominence thanks to Michael Moore.
That's right, Fahrenheit 9/11.
Pointing out that George Bush Sr. was on their board. They profited massively because they had these big investments in the defense industry when we decided to go to war on false pretenses in Iraq and also, you know, in Afghanistan to get the bad guys. So, yeah, those are the types of entities and individuals that both our parties love to surround themselves with and ultimately aspire to be part of that class rather than aspiring, I don't know, to maybe serve you and make sure you can enjoy a nice Thanksgiving dinner as well.
Yeah, you can't create a better uniparty meme than Glenn Youngkin, the recently governor-elect of the state of Virginia, being the former co-CEO of the Carlyle Group, while the Democratic president of the United States staying in the Carlyle Group founder's home in Nantucket. That just goes to show you where we are. It's like you can't escape because these people have tentacles and hands in both parties, and they're making sure that their interests are absolutely represented whenever it comes to the table. And there's just nothing that you can really get. There's no way to skirt it on the national political stage on the current environment. And I really got to say, like with Biden, do you not think the man would have better political instincts than this? What is wrong with you?
Yeah.
You know, if you go and you read, like Bill Clinton, I read Bill Clinton's biography. He was having a really tough time in 93 in terms of his political environment. Very similar, actually. And they were like, look, sir, people think you're out of touch. People think that you're pushing stuff that is not in line with us. So we need to get your ass out west and put you on a horse. He did like a horse riding thing where he wore a hat. It looked ridiculous. Okay, he's a Yale educated Georgetown lawyer, which is fine. You know, he happens to have an accent, but at the same time, they at least tried to put him in. You know, tried to make him seem as if he was more, you know, in tune with the average American. I mean, white working class people are the people who elected Bill Clinton too, ultimately. And so you look then at Biden, and he just doesn't care. I mean, the pretense at the lowest point in your presidency to go and have vacation and hang out at a billionaire's house in Nantucket, I can't imagine, you know, in terms of the optics. It's such a dumb move. Obama at least waited until he left office to start doing this type of stuff. But, you know, it's a mask-off moment. It just shows us who these people really are.
Indeed. Hey guys, thanks so much for watching.
That's right. Just as a reminder, you can become a premium subscriber today. Watch the full show completely uncut. Our reactions to each other's monologues. You get to listen to it. You get to ask us questions. All that good stuff. Link is right there in the description or at breakingpoints.com.
Best of all, great way to say screw you to the mainstream media.